थर्ड टाइप ऑफ सॉल्ट, सॉल्ट ऑफ वीक एसिड एंड स्ट्रॉन्ग बेस. सपोज वी हैव द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ CH3COONA, विच इज कॉल्ड एज सोडियम एसिटेट. सोडियम एसिटेट इज द सॉल्ट ऑफ वीक एसिड एंड स्ट्रॉन्ग बेस. वेन इट रिएक्ट्स विद वॉटर H2O, इट विल गिव यू द करस्पॉन्डिंग एसिड एंड बेस. CH3CONA इज अ सॉल्ट ऑफ वीक एसिड CH3COOH, विच इज कॉल्ड एज एसिटिक एसिड, प्लस इट इज द सॉल्ट ऑफ स्ट्रॉन्ग बेस दैट इज NaOH. सो रिमेंबर द रिएक्शन इज लाइक दिस. CH3COONA when it react with water it will give you weak acid CH3COOH and strong base NaOH. So you can say that this is the salt of weak acid and strong base. Now here CH3COONA, it is a salt, so it will completely ionize. You have to remember the ionization of CH3COONA. It will give anion CH3COO minus and cation Na plus plus H2O as it is, will give weak acid CH3COH. Weak acid is mostly in the form of molecules, and so you can show the ionization of CH3COOH plus NaOH is a strong base, and so it is completely in the form of ions, Na plus ions and OH minus ions. As it is a base, it will produce OH minus ions. Now here, see this, in this reaction Na plus ions are common, so Na plus ions will be cancelled. So the reaction remaining will be CH3COO minus plus H2O will give you CH3COOH, weak acid remaining as it is, plus OH minus. Here CH3COO minus means this is the negatively charged ion of the salt, which is called as anion. Anion of the salt react with water to give what will be obtained here, OH minus ions. OH minus ions are free, so the solution will become basic in nature. So remember, for the salt of weak acid and strong base, hydrolysis can be defined as the reaction in which anion of the salt react with water to give basic nature to the solution. If you take any example of this type of salt, the same type of reaction will be obtained here. The negatively charged ion, that is anion of the salt, will react with water. You can obtain the weak acid and OH minus ions are free, so the solution will become basic in nature. Remember, for the salt of weak acid and strong base, the aqueous solution of this type of salt is basic in nature, and due to this you can say that in the aqueous solution of such type of salt, red litmus will turn to blue. Remember here, when the reaction takes place between salt of weak acid and strong base and water, the aqueous solution will turn red litmus to blue because the solution is basic in nature. Now last type of salt, salt of weak acid and weak base. We know different examples, but we have to explain this in different ways. Suppose we have a salt BA. BA is a salt. Suppose it is a salt of, in general we have denoted this salt as BA. It is a salt of weak acid and weak base. When it reacts with water, it will give you acid, which is weak, and you know that any acid is generally represented by HA plus BOH, which is a base. In general, salt is represented by BA. When BA reacts with water, it will give you weak acid HA and weak base BOH. Now here this reaction can be shown as B plus plus A minus, because this is a salt, so it is completely ionized to give ions, that is B plus and A minus. they react with water to give HA, which is a weak acid. So mostly it is in the form of molecules. Weak base BOH, mostly it is in the form of molecules. So this is the reaction for hydrolysis of salt of weak acid and weak base. Now what is the nature of the solution? Can it be neutral? Can it be acidic or basic? Here we shall see. HA and BOH, both are weak. HA is weak acid and BOH is weak base. But the strength of this acid depends upon value of Ka. Strength of this base depend upon value of Kb, which is called a dissociation constant of acid and dissociation constant of base. And therefore, remember that for such type of salt, if the strength of acid or acid is more stronger than base, that means if the value of Ka is greater than value of Kb, that is, you can say that both are weak, but amongst these two, Ka is greater than Kb, that is, HA is more stronger than BOH, and for that type of salt, the solution will be acidic. Second, when base is more stronger than acid, both are weak, but the base is more stronger than acid, that means Kb is greater than Ka, or Ka is less than Kb, then you can say that here the solution is basic in nature. And sometimes here both are same type or they are having same strength, that is value of Ka is equal to Kb, then that solution will be neutral. So remember that for salt of weak acid and weak base, you can't determine the nature of the solution directly, whether it is acidic or basic or neutral. It will depend upon the value of Ka and Kb. If Ka is greater than Kb, the solution is acidic in nature. When Ka is less than Kb, the solution is basic in nature. And when Ka is equal to Kb, then the solution is neutral in nature. So for this type of salt, you must know the value of Ka and Kb. We shall see the examples of this hydrolysis of this type of salt. Suppose we have the example of first type of salt, NH4F. NH4F, ammonium fluoride. Ammonium fluoride is a salt of NH4OH, which is a weak base, and HF, which is a weak acid. And so you can write the hydrolysis reaction for such type of salt, NH4F, when it react with water, you can obtain HF plus NH4OH. HF plus NH4OH. HF is weak acid and NH4OH is a weak base. Now, ionization theory. According to this theory, NH4F is a salt, so it will completely ionize to give NH4 plus ions plus F minus ions plus H2O. Here, HF, it is weak acid, it will remain in molecular state. NH4OH is a weak base, it will remain in the molecular state. That is, here acid and base both are produced. But remember here, for HF, the value of K is 7.2 into 10 raised to minus 4. It is a weak acid. Value of K for this acid is 7.2 into 10 raised to minus 4. And NH4OH is weak base. And value of Kb for this is 1.8 into 10 raised to minus 5. See, if you compare these values, both are weak, but here HF is more stronger than NH4OH. That is, you can say that for this salt, Ka is greater than Kb, and therefore the solution will be acidic in nature. Here, for the salt of weak acid and weak base, we have taken the first example, that is NH4F. Here, as Ka is greater than Kb, the solution is acidic in nature. Suppose we have the second example for such type of salt, NH4CN. NH4CN, that is ammonium cyanide. Now, for ammonium cyanide, when it reacts with water, hydrolysis reaction will take place. You can obtain acid, that is HCN, plus base NH4OH. So you can say that NH4CN is a salt of weak acid HCN and weak base NH4OH. Here both are weak, and the nature of this solution, you can write the ionization reaction again, NH4 plus plus CN minus will give you will react with water to give you HCN and NH4OH. Now K for HCN is 4 into 10 raised to minus 10, and you know KB for NH4OH is 1.8 into 10 raised to minus 5. Now if you compare these values, you can say that KB is greater than KA or KA is less than KB. So what will happen here? The concentration of OH minus ions will be more than concentration of H plus ions. Remember here, the ionization of NH4OH will be to the more extent than the ionization of HCN. So concentration of OH minus ions will be more than concentration of HCN, and so the solution will be basic in nature. Okay. Third, suppose we have the example of CS3COONH4. Suppose we have the next example of same type of salt, that is salt of weak acid and weak base, CS3COONH4. It is a salt of, when it reacts with water, it will give you corresponding acid and base. It is a salt of CS3COOH, which is weak acid, and NH4OH, which is a weak base. It will ionize to give CS3CO minus ions plus NH4 plus ions. They react with water to give weak acid CS3COOH and weak base NH4OH. Now if you compare the strength of these two acids and bases, here Ka value for CS3COOH is 1.8 into 10 raised to minus 5, and for NH4OH value of Kb is equal to 1.8 into 10 raised to minus 5. Both are same, that is Ka is equal to Kb. That means the number of H plus ions produced from CS3COOH is equal to number of OH minus ions produced from NH4OH. So H plus ions and OH minus ions, they will combine with each other. The solution will become neutral, and so you can say that for this salt, the solution is neutral in nature. So for this salt of weak acid and weak base, what happens here, cation and anion of this salt, both the salts, both the ions of this salt react with water to give sometimes acidic nature to the solution, sometimes the solution is basic in nature, and sometimes the solution is neutral in nature. So for such type of salt, you can say that hydrolysis is a reaction in which cation and anion react with water to give acidic or basic or neutral nature to the solution is called as hydrolysis. Now for all these types of salt, hydrolysis can be defined as the reaction in which cation or anion or both the ions of the salt react with water to give acidic or basic or neutral nature to the solution. Now hydrolysis can be explained by taking some other examples also. We can determine aqueous nature of aqueous solution of any type of salt which is given to you, and determine what happens to the litmus paper. For example, suppose we have in aqueous solution of sodium carbonate, that is Na2CO3, red litmus turns to blue. How we can explain this? It can be explained on the basis of hydrolysis reaction. For that, you have to explain the hydrolysis reaction of this type of salt, that is Na2CO3. When Na2CO3 dissolves in water, it will give you the corresponding acid and base. Na2CO3 is a salt of H2CO3 and NaOH. So when Na2CO3 reacts with water, it will give you NaOH and H2CO3. For balancing the reaction, we have taken here twice H2O,
we will obtain here twice NaOH. Now, Na2CO3 is a salt, and so it will completely ionize to give Na plus ions and CO3 minus minus ions, and therefore 2Na plus plus CO3 minus minus will plus H2O, it will give you 2Na plus plus 2OH minus plus H2CO3. Now here again Na plus ions will be cancelled, and the reaction will be anion of the salt react with water to give OH minus ions, and weak acid will be produced. Now OH minus ions in this solution are free, and therefore you can say that this solution is basic in nature, but due to the basic nature here the red litmus will turn to blue in this solution. Like this, for any type of salt you can determine what happens to the litmus paper. When the solution is basic, red litmus will turn blue. That is, for the salt of weak acid and strong base, you can say that in the aqueous solution red litmus will turn blue. Suppose we have the example of salt of strong acid and weak base, you can say that the solution will be acidic in nature, and in that solution blue litmus will turn to red. Like this, you have to write the reaction of hydrolysis for that salt. You have to show which ions are produced, H plus or OH minus ions are free. If H plus ions are free, you can say the solution is acidic, blue litmus will turn red. If OH minus ions are free, you can say red litmus will turn to blue. Now see the another effect of hydrolysis. Aqueous solution of CuSO4 is turbid. When in the laboratory, if you prepare CuSO4 solution, CuSO4 is dissolved in water, you can't obtain clear solution. You can obtain the solution somewhat turbid in nature. But why it is obtained turbid? It can be explained by the hydrolysis reaction of CuSO4. When CuSO4 is dissolved in water, it will react with water to give H2SO4, that is strong acid, and COOH twice, which is a weak base. So this is hydrolysis of CuSO4. Here Cu plus plus ions and SO4 minus minus ions will be produced. They will react with water to give H plus ions, SO4 minus minus ions, and COOH twice. Here SO4 minus minus ions will be cancelled, and you can say that Cu plus plus ions will react with water to give H plus ions and COOH twice. Here the solution is acidic in nature, but the question is why the solution is turbid. Here remember that CuOH twice, which is produced, that is it is a weak base. Remember, this CuOH twice is not completely soluble in water. It is very very less soluble in water. That is called as sparingly soluble. So CuOH twice is sparingly soluble in water, and therefore the solution is not clear. It is somewhat turbid in nature. And so when you have to prepare clear solution of CuSO4, here to obtain clear solution, small amount of H2SO4 is added. Why H2SO4 is added? Remember, H2SO4 is strong acid. We are adding H2SO4 means we are adding H plus ions, because H2SO4 in aqueous solution will give you H plus ions. That means we are increasing the concentration of H plus ions. Remember Lasch-Attali's principle. According to Lasch-Attali's principle, here we are increasing the concentration of the products, means the system will try to decrease the concentration of products, that is concentration of H plus ions will be decreased, and to decrease the concentration of H plus ions, these H plus ions will react with CuOH twice. That means the concentration of CuOH twice or the quantity of CuOH twice will be decreased, and therefore the solution will become clear. And remember that to obtain clear solution of CuSO4, small amount of H2SO4 is added. Like this, it can be explained on the basis of hydrolysis of CuSO4. Today we have completed hydrolysis of the salts.